Hey guys, it is Julie here with TibRanks. In today's video, we're taking a look at three monster growth stocks that could reach new highs. We are going to take a look at each of these companies and what it is that they do, plus how analysts are rating them and what price targets they are giving for their future. Just before we get into that, guys, I want to take a quick second to ask you a favor. I'm wanting to do a video addressing all of your questions about how to best utilize some of the TibRanks tools and investing questions in general. So if you have any questions or specific tools that you would like to see how to use, make sure to leave your thoughts in the comments down below. All right, now let's get right into these three growth stocks, starting off with Amyris Incorporated. Amyris trades under the ticker AMRS and is currently priced at $22.10 per share. Now, Amyris is a biotech company. However, they don't deal with the typical pharmaceuticals that you'd expect. They focus on developing synthetic chemical replacements for common petroleum, plant, and animal-based products. They focus on three different divisions: health and wellness, where they're developing low-cost nutraceuticals to pioneering a zero-calorie sugar replacement; clean beauty, where they are mainstreaming sustainability through their cosmetic ingredients and products; and flavors and fragrances, providing pure, reliable, and sustainable ingredients to the largest fragrance and flavor houses in the world. For Amyris, 2020 was a year of execution and transformation. They delivered about 200% consumer revenue growth and achieved positive Q4 adjusted EBITDA. They delivered 6 new ingredients at scale versus their target of 2 to 3, and they reduced their debt from $297 million to below $150 million as of March 1st this year. From their clean skincare, Biossance, their baby and personal care, Pipette, and alternative sweetener, Purecane, they saw fourth quarter year-over-year growth of 161% and full year-over-year growth of nearly 200%. Q4 marked the third consecutive quarter of record product sales. The company reported $80 million in total sales, more than doubling the previous quarter's results. Of that, the $35 million in product revenue was up 71% year-over-year. The company also saw a significant year-over-year increase in gross margins, from 56 to 66%. The increasing sales led to full-year revenues of $173 million, a 13% year-over-year gain. For 2021, their full-year total revenue is expected to be near $400 million, which is well above the consensus forecast of $231 million. They also expect to further reduce their debt down below $100 million by the third quarter of 2021. Covering the stock is five-star analyst Craig Irwin from Roth Capital. He points out that Amyris is well positioned to maintain its blistering pace, saying that long-term growth is underpinned by a strong pipeline of new molecules in development with strategic partners. With the 13 ingredients in the market and 18 in active development, we expect continued healthy portfolio expansion as these come to market through 2025. Management expects to add another 8 to 10 ingredients to the active development pipeline in 2021, maintaining a broad channel for expanding long-term product and ingredient potential. Currently, there are 4 analysts with ratings on the Amyris stock, and it comes in as a strong buy, with an average price target of $25.50 for about a 15% potential upside. One of those ratings, however, is a couple months old, and although it is a buy, it has a negative downside of about 60%, which is definitely bringing down our average. If we look at our more recent ratings that both came in 12 days ago, they're much higher. Craig Irwin comes in with a buy rating and a $33 price target for nearly a 50% potential upside, and Amit Dayal from H.C. Wainwright gives it a $35 price target for about a 58% potential upside. Amyris also comes in as a 10 out of 10 on the TibRanks Top Smart Score. This is based on those strong buy ratings, but also bullish news sentiment and blogger opinions, positive momentum from TibRanks investors, and increased hedge fund activity. The second company on our list today is Clean Energy Fuels. They trade under the ticker CLNE and are currently priced at $15.45 per share. Clean Energy is the leader in renewable natural gas for transportation. RNG is the only fuel available for heavy-duty vehicles that can have carbon-negative emissions. And we know lately there is a lot more focus for big companies to go green or emission-free, so this is a very fast-growing sector. They have a network of over 550 LNG and CNG fueling stations, and their stations are fueling service vehicles in about 37 plus major airports, and their strategically located truck-friendly CNG and LNG fueling stations are designed to keep heavy-duty fleets fueled up and on the road. They provide complete, scalable fueling solutions, offering everything you need from modifying your existing vehicle maintenance facilities to building and operating stations to guiding and financing options. They've paved the way in new fueling equipment technologies and manufacturing. In early February, Clean Energy announced a major multi-year contract to provide the LA County Metro system, the largest bus fleet in the US, with 47.5 million gallons of RNG. The agreement is part of a move by the LA Metro to low-carbon fuels. Clean Energy was awarded 3 fueling depots for 5 years, with an option to extend the contract for an additional 3. This is in addition to 5 fueling depots with Clean Energy already operating for Metro. Covering the clean energy fuel stock for Craig Hallam is 5-star analyst Eric Stein. He says, "We think it is becoming increasingly clear that natural gas and RNG is going to be a critical fuel as part of the decarbonization of transportation, with Amazon's initial deployment an exclamation point. With Clean Energy's dominant position and RNG plans, the significant financial impact of RNG, which is amplified by the increased contribution of low CI RNG, and the most expansive station footprint, we see Clean Energy as an ideal investment in natural gas, and also note it is one of the few pure-play investments in renewable natural gas." And there are 4 analysts in total with current ratings on the clean energy stock. It comes in as a strong buy, with 3 buy ratings and 1 hold. The average price target is $23 per share for about a 48% potential upside. The most recent rating was that hold rating from Raymond James, and it didn't come with a price target. Our highest rating comes from Lake Street, with a $27 price target for nearly a 75% potential upside. And once again, we have a stock that scores 10 out of 10 on our TipRanks Top Smart Score, based on those strong buy ratings, but also bullish blogger and news sentiment, increased hedge fund activity, and positive technicals. And last but not least today, we have Amatis. Trading under the ticker AMTX, they're currently priced at $19 per share. Amatis is another company focusing on renewable fuels. Their main products are ethanol and biodiesel, along with glycerin, an important industrial chemical. The company doesn't rest on one sector, however, and has a broad production portfolio that also includes distiller grains, edible oils, and palm olein, and other food products. They market heavily in India's food sector and the California Central Valley. They have seen a lot of growth this year, and a significant portion of that came after their announcement that they will be starting a carbon zero plant to produce renewable truck and jet fuels with a capacity of 23 million gallons per year. The company has also published a 5-year growth plan targeting $1 billion in total revenue by 2025. Covering the stock is Amit Dayal from H.C. Wainwright, who not only is a 5-star analyst, but is actually ranked number 9 on TipRanks out of over 7,300 analysts. He says that, "We believe the company is emerging as one of the leaders in implementing a zero to negative carbon intensity strategy to bring renewable fuels to the market that should be supportive of a superior margin profile relative to competitors. We also believe that the company has timed these initiatives well during a very friendly federal regulatory environment, improving the probability of success." Now, there are just 2 current analyst ratings on the Amatis stock, but they both come in as a buy, with an average price target of $26.50 per share for nearly a 40% potential upside. Amit has the highest price target at $28 per share for a 47% potential upside. So there we have 3 stocks that have already seen some great growth this year, but analysts think still have room to grow. I would love to hear your thoughts on these 3 stocks, so make sure to leave your comments down below. And don't forget to ask any questions about different TipRanks tools that you would like to learn how to use better. Don't forget that I am here Monday through Friday with our pre-market update videos, where we're getting you up to speed with everything you need to know before the opening bell. So make sure that you hit that subscribe button. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you here tomorrow morning.